From the police state to tectonic plates, Dutch Sense and Tattoo take the temperature of tyranny on Freedom Frequency 1871, coming to you live now.
This is America. We have founding fathers that wrote a constitution that we haven't lived by in 142 years.
Were they serious when they said they planned on owning the weather by 2025?
And if you're not pissed off, there's something wrong with you right now.
Have you guys seen what's going on outside your door lately? Need I remind you?
This is America! Are y'all gonna allow it to be Russia?
Hello, everyone. Welcome into Freedom Frequency 1871. This is your host, Dutch Sinse. And we have Tattoot also on here with us. Tat, you there?
Hello, everybody.
Excellent. Excellent. Hope you guys all had a good past couple weeks. Today is, of course, the 14th of February, and we are in the middle of another winter Arctic blast across most of the United States and most of the Northern Hemisphere, actually, across Europe as well. The only place that's somewhat warm seems to be Russia right now. And that's with the Olympics, of course. That seems kind of ironic. And so this past 2 weeks, last week we ran Genetically Modified Society. I wasn't able to make the show due to personal events in real life, but we were able to run Genetically Modified Society and got a good response from that. People really appreciated that. And that covers, of course, the topics of weather modification and genetically modified food. And I did that with Julio over the course of 2012 into 2013. He's our intrepid traveling reporter that we sent around the country to the weather modification conferences. So that's, you know, what happened last week. Over the course of this last week, we had a series of stories come out, and I'm going to briefly go over these before we get into tonight's main topic, which is going to be HAARP and radio frequency, directed energy weapons, weather modification. But before we get into that, let's just kind of briefly touch on what happened this week for most of us in the country, which is another Arctic blast blew through the South, left huge layers of ice and snow across Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, and then blew up the East Coast, dumping a ton of snow. And as that was happening, Tattoot and I were discussing a few things behind the scenes about just the general cooling that's been happening. And that led Tattoot to go over to our joint, we have a joint shared radar page where we stream all these different live feeds from around the world. And Tat went back on the polar ice concentration levels feed for the past 25 years, going back to the late 70s. And he compared the late 70s, 80s, 90s to today's current ice pack and proved that the North Pole is 100% ice concentration now, currently, and even more so compared to years prior. And within a day of Tattoot putting that video out, I got a huge response online. Next thing you know, mainstream news puts out an article or a series of articles saying that global cooling is advancing and that global warming is on, quote, hiatus. And they're trying to blame a wind coming off the North Pacific for cooling the entire planet down and not allowing global warming to continue like they said it would. Remember, the ice caps were supposed to melt and Greenland was supposed to melt. Cities were supposed to be underwater. And none of that's been happening. And now they're saying it's on hiatus. They say, don't worry, it's going to come back. But this is just a symptom of climate change. Okay?
What happened to global warming? And they changed the word climate change to suit their needs. Don't forget that, people. Don't ever forget that.
It's a switch of terms, guys. We noticed this when we were doing the documentary, Genetically Modified Society, that a lot of the, quote, warmers were starting to switch over to this new term, climate change. Climate change can mean anything. It could mean drought. It could mean cold. It could mean tornadoes. It could mean fair weather. In a place that doesn't normally have fair weather, let's say the North Pole, right? So these terms, the switch in terms from global warming to climate change, and the announcement that the globe is actually cooling, or at least global warming is on hiatus. And as we know with temperatures, they never remain constant. There is no such thing as it just stopping warming. If it's stopping warming, it's starting cooling. That's the way the temperature goes. It either goes up or down. It doesn't really hover, especially globally. We're talking about vast areas here. So that coming out the day after Tattooed put out the announcement that the North Pole is 100% ice concentration, it got several thousand views all across social media. I don't know if they're 100% related, but maybe they were holding the story until the appropriate time for release. Whatever the outcome, that's their take on it. That's the scientists talking about this. This is not our take. This is their words. Global warming's on hiatus. Also in the news, a 7.0 magnitude earthquake struck in western China, and it caused a lot of damage, but it didn't make much news because of the Olympics and the snowstorm happening across the U.S. And it's not plastic snow, folks. Let's just settle that again. It's regular snow. Could be weather modification, which we've touched on now for the last 2 weeks on cloud seeding. Let's see, what else happened in the news this week? Okay, we also had a strange radar signal appear off the western coast of Australia. And Tattooed put out a video today where they have since come out and blamed it, or the military has taken credit for this S-shaped radar return. And there's multiple explanations. That's the funny part. Some are saying in the military that it's just a maneuver out to sea. And then others are saying there is no explanation and that it has something to do with the maneuvers out to sea. So it's happening at a 100 nautical mile radius right on the perimeter of the radar itself, of the weather radar. It's picking up this strange S-shaped return. Now, I made a video on it, went and looked up the area. And, of course, we have the Harold Holt, Exmouth, Australia, VLF, and now high frequency station to the north. And that is the Australian equivalent, let's say, of, let's call it their HAARP. But it does more VLF communications for submarine communications to the South Pole. That takes us directly in to tonight's topic, which is HAARP, the High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program based out of Gakona, Alaska. Now, before I get into this full explanation of weather modification, radio frequency, directed energy weapons, we have to first kind of go back maybe 2.5-3 years to when I first got my start on YouTube. How did I go down this odyssey? How did I get down this road where I have a huge post now covering the topic of radio frequency manipulation of the atmosphere, ionosphere, and even in the Earth? How did this come about? Myself, being a computer technician and working in the telecom industry for a long time, I had no background in plasma physics, okay? This is a process of learning that happened for me due to a discovery, if you want to call it that, something that I noticed happening on radar. Now, we'll get into how radar and HAARP are related in just a little bit. But to sum up my experience, in early 2011, end of 2010, there were a series of animal deaths that started to happen in the Midwest. A series of birds and fish turning up, the birds especially, exploded from the inside. And nobody knew what was going on. Of course, I didn't know either. We're just documenting these stories. And someone sends me a link saying, hey, there's something strange happening on radar over BB, Arkansas. You need to go check it. And I went and looked, and lo and behold, there's a round signature over North Little Rock, okay? And I didn't know what it was, just made note of it and just filed that away into the back of my head. Made a video on it, didn't get any views. I didn't know what to make of it. I didn't even know what to call it. A few weeks later, I'm again watching radar. It's wintertime here in St. Louis, right after New Year's, and a storm system is blowing up. Okay, and they're forecasting tornadoes to come into the region down in Arkansas, down over BB, over the same area that we saw the strange anomaly and the animals dead. And of course, that intrigued me. I was watching, trying to see what was going to happen down there. And of course, tornadoes blew right across the same area that the radar return appeared on. Okay. So, and that was just within a few weeks. Now, that was weeks time. And I said, that might be related, might not be. It's too long of a time. You know, we have to watch more to see what's happening. And as I'm watching, I see a circular return appear, and this is real time on radar. As I'm watching the one, I see a circular return appear over southern Illinois, just east of me. Okay, and it was right along the New Madrid seismic zone. And it was a different type of circular return than the one that we were seeing in Beebe. This one was round, it was defined, it was hollow at the center, and it was pulsing. And I thought it might be the sign of an earthquake. I didn't know what to make of it. So I recorded the time, made a video, didn't release the video at first. I waited a day because I didn't know what to call it. And a day later, after I released the video saying, hey, I think there might be an earthquake at the spot, Flora, Illinois. And this, keep in mind, this is the middle of winter. A freak storm blew up the day after this other storm system blew through, and a tornado kicked up and went right over that area, the little round circle that I saw on radar. And I was expecting there to be an earthquake there, and instead a tornado hit. Now, that's twice now that I've seen a circular return with a tornado going in the center of it in the wintertime. And that then led me to think about what I was seeing. Upon realizing that there was something going on, that there could be a possibility that these tornadoes are going into the center of these rings, that's what led me down the road to go look into HAARP. Now, HAARP, the High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program in Alaska, is not causing the circular returns that we're seeing on radar. However, they are similar in the same aspect that they are radio frequency projected from a ground-based station. This led to a slang term being developed amongst us researchers online, specifically myself and about two or three other guys that I was talking to, and we started to call them HAARP rings, the radar pulses that we were seeing. And that led into the discoveries having to do with HAARP. At the time, at the end of 2010, going into 2011, even though people have been talking about HAARP for several years, going back to the mid-90s with Dr. Nick Begich and these documentaries, it was in a conspiracy realm that people were saying, even as of 2009, that HAARP didn't exist, that it was just a research facility, just a place where they do minor experiments, scientific research in the ionosphere. Well, unfortunately, that is a gross dumbing down of the actual operations that are occurring at HAARP in Alaska. Now, why is HAARP in Alaska so important? HAARP in Alaska is an antenna array. And now, before I get into this, let me see if we can post the link into the chat room now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This link here is the culmination of about 2.5-3 years worth of work. And for those who are just listening, there will be a link. Hopefully, we can post this maybe on the Freedom Frequency actual page at some point or below the videos as we post these so you can follow along. What we're going to go over tonight is basically a brief overview of each discovery that we've posted over the course of the last 2.5 years. If I get to the point where 2 hours is reached and we're unable to go through this post, we will carry on next week or for the next 2 weeks if we have to get through this. Now, the post starts out with a picture of the facility. And the facility is a multiple acre wide square that has a series of antennas. Now, I believe, Tat, isn't it 188?
Yes. No, 180.
180 antennas, and then some smaller antennas that are actually in the building on what looks like a table. And the HAARP facility projects radio frequency in the megahertz band up into the atmosphere and ionosphere. Simply put, it beams radio frequency in multiple directions. They can direct the antennas, not by turning them, but by literally modulating them with power. They can turn the radio frequency and steer it west, east, north, south, up, and possibly even down into the Earth. Now, in the megahertz band, there's been, well, 40, 50 years worth of work done. And if the producer is scrolling down, we'll just see a first picture on here. You're going to see a picture of John F. Kennedy. And here he is in 1961 saying this, quote, and this is before the UN General Assembly, "We shall propose further cooperative efforts between all nations in weather prediction and eventually in weather control." That's President John F. Kennedy, September 25th, 1961. Now, I've got another picture directly below that, which is a picture of Secretary of Defense William Cohen in the mid-1990s, late 90s, and he was the defense secretary for Bill Clinton. And let me give you his quote. Quote, "Others are engaging even in an eco-type of terrorism whereby they can alter the climate, set off earthquakes and volcanoes remotely through the use of electromagnetic waves. Weather warfare." Okay, that's a huge transition from John F. Kennedy's aspirations of possible weather control to mid to late 90s. People are using this for terrorism, or could use it for terrorism, to set off volcanoes electromagnetically, remotely. Now, over the last year, in 2013, a bunch of disinformation started to appear online about HAARP in Alaska. It started with a false story being reported verbally below someone's video on YouTube, of all things. A science researcher said, quote, "HAARP has been decommissioned." Now, we took issue with that. We debunked that. We showed, at the time, the 2012 and 2013 budget. Okay? And the producer, right below the weather warfare picture, you should be able to see the 2012 and 2013 budget on my page. And let me read it to you, just in case people were wondering what they are doing in 2012 and 2013 when HAARP is being reported to be closed down. This is what's actually being done. And I've got the 2014 schedule too, which we can go over in a minute, but I'll read you the 2012 and 2013 first. And this is, again, while they're saying that HAARP is closed, we have the U.S. Air Force and DARPA partnered up in a thrust. This thrust will obtain insights into physical aspects of natural phenomenon, such as magnetospheric substorms, fire, lightning, and geophysical phenomenon. New fundamental understandings of these phenomenon will enable the ability to predict and exploit these physical processes, especially with regard to communications. A major emphasis of this thrust is to provide predictive models for the interactions between plasmas and electromagnetic waves across a range of energy and length scales and into new regimes. Specific projects that fall under this heading are foundational studies on the initiation, propagation, and attachment of lightning and their associated emissions, the critical factors affecting magnetospheric substorms, the generation and amplification of extremely low frequency, ultra low frequency radiation in the ionosphere utilizing the High Frequency Active Aurora Research Program transmitter. And, of course, and then it finishes off, and understanding the quantifying interaction of electromagnetic and acoustic waves with the plasma within flames. Let me read that to you again. Understanding and quantifying the interaction of electromagnetic and acoustic waves with the plasma in flames. Now, what did I just read to you there? I just read to you what they're doing in 2012 and 2013 when they told you it's been shut down and they shut down the website. They turned off the website. That's the only thing that's been turned off. And it was reported on an amateur radio site for some reason that everybody believed that it's been closed down and shuttered and abandoned because of Clean Air Act standards that the diesel generators, quote, they said diesel generators, plural, are too dirty and they had to shut down HAARP. Now, the problem is there's one locomotive diesel generator in the building and it's properly vented and it meets all Clean Air Act standards. It's a diesel generator. And that was 2012 and 2013. Now, the producer has a PDF file and it's titled DARPA FY 2014. Okay. And I don't know if he'll be able to open that up. We're going to go to page 55 on this. And on page 55, they have 2013 and 2014 posted. Okay. And it's the same description. It's the same experiments being carried on into 2014. Manipulating fire, manipulating lightning. Currently in 2014, guys, if they're manipulating fire, that's, you think they're making fire up in the atmosphere? No, they're talking about manipulating fire at a ground level. How does plasma interact and manipulate fire? Lightning, directing lightning. What if they could direct lightning to cause fire and then cause the fire to explode up, or vice versa, cause the fire to shrink? What if they could contain a fire using radio frequency? That's what they're talking about doing. That's what they're doing now. You don't have to take my word for it. There's the budget. They've already paid for it. And that's in millions. Now, before we go down the list even further, okay, we're already at the budgets, okay, there is another PDF that I would like the producer to show you, and it's titled Russell UF Talk. And this is a 2011 PDF. And again, you guys who can't see this, I will read it to you and describe it. This was put out in November of 2011 by the U.S. Air Force and the Air Force Research Laboratories, the AFRL. And it shows on page 21 that they have allocated budgets for HAARP going fiscal year 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Going into 17, the Air Force has already paid for and budgeted out experiments at HAARP, and it progressively goes up in millions, 19.2 million or 17.8 million this year, 19.2 million next year, 21.7 million next year, the next year, and in 17, 22.6 million. And what are they going to be doing? Plasmas and high energy density non-equilibrium process studies. And they're going to pursue the understanding of fundamental plasma and nonlinear electromagnetic phenomenon and the nonlinear response of materials to high electric and magnetic fields. And here's what at the description, here's the description, technical horizons that they're aiming to complete: advanced RF apertures, radio frequency apertures, directed energy effects, radiation-hardened electronics to, of course, withstand these processes, HPM, high-powered microwaves, okay? And if you go down one more page, page 22, this is where they mention HAARP. They mention artificial ionization layers. The effect of energy input into the ionosphere is researched at the HAARP ionospheric heater in Alaska. The HF, high-frequency radiation, to heat the ionosphere generated artificial layers. And they have a diagram over on the right. They show the natural ionization. They show the artificial ionization done via radio frequency. And then look what they have right there in the center, guys. It says ring in quotes. It's a project study going on through, looks like, fiscal year 2017 to study HAARP rings. And rings is in quote. And this is from November of 2011, 1 year after I came out with HAARP rings. Now, I'm not saying they're fully related, but they wrote this paper after. Now, to get back to the post, we just showed you now.
We got a break in about 5 minutes, buddy.
Perfect. We just showed you and debunked all the reports that HAARP closed down. And I would challenge any of you to find an official government report that says that HAARP shut down, shuttered, closed, or was decommissioned due to what the story said, which is that HAARP was shuttered due to diesel generators. And I think it's the A-R-R-R-L.
A-R-R-L. Yes.
Oh, is it two R's? Okay. Yeah, the A-R-R-L is bunk. it's a bunk story. And then it was promoted across alternative media, InfoWars, Drudge Report, a bunch of YouTubers all repeated the same story. Meanwhile, I'm sitting over here flagging everybody down saying, hey, look, here's the documents that show that they are budgeted out for the next several years and that it's already currently being active up in Alaska, even though that the website has been turned off. Now, why is this so important? Why are we even talking about this tonight? This all plays into the topic of weather modification. Yes, HAARP and weather modification. Now, we're going to go into the Air Force owning the weather by 2025. This is the first document that we're going to go into, and we'll get into this most likely after the break. But I can read a little bit to you now just to give you a brief overview, okay? In the late 90s, a series of captains and different researchers in the military came up with a plan called Owning the Weather by 2025. And it involves the use of radio frequency, high-powered microwaves, lasers, directed energy weapons to manipulate the atmosphere and ionosphere to have a weather effect. And we're talking about enemy force degradation. We're talking about moving fog on and off airfields instantly, those sorts of effects. We're talking about precipitation enhancement to be able to flood lines of communication for the enemy, precipitation denial, disrupt communications for radar, space weather, disable and destroy space assets, deny concealment for fog and cloud removal, or increase vulnerability. Okay, I mean, these are their descriptions that I'm reading to you from the Air Force Owning the Weather 2025 document. And the real question, this is in the intro to our radio show, which is, do you believe that they're serious? Do you believe the Air Force is serious when they say that they plan on owning the weather by 2025? I believe them. I believe that they're making every effort and step to get to that, and that while we, the people, are in kind of like a process of denial about what can be done, they are out there doing it. I intend to prove that to you tonight. We only have a few minutes before the break. Before we go down the list any further, I would like to just quickly address the past several weeks of disinformation appearing on YouTube. And not just YouTube, but in social media. But YouTube is the place where this begins. This past week, and I'll leave them unnamed, someone put out a video saying that a large image was seen, a large microwave image was seen on the morphed microwave background imagery. And they claimed that it was evidence of HAARP. Unfortunately, it's not. And this video went viral. It went to, you know, 50,000 views and across the world. And what it is, what we are seeing, if you see a large pulse appearing on the mimic, we are seeing an incoming solar flare. And Tat can speak to this as well really quick. We got about 2 minutes still before the break. So the incoming flash that you see on the mimic on the microwave background imagery is a solar flare. It's incoming particles, and it's going right across the Earth. And you'll notice that when those flashes appear, that they coincide with the facing direction towards the sun on the day that the flare is arriving. So, for instance, this person who made this recent video, if they would have gone back and checked the solar feed from a day and a half earlier, 2 days earlier, they would have seen a large M-class flare that erupted off the sun that sent a blast of particles towards the Earth. And then when it arrives, that's when we see it on these feeds. And guess what happened there, by the way? A 6.0 earthquake upon arrival. Again, South Sandwich Islands. That's the second time this has happened since we've been watching. When you see a flash appear from the sun, solar flare blast comes in.
But we do have one problem with on there. You do every once in a while see a round ring and a square ring, or not a square ring, but a square. And those do cause other problems. That didn't come from the sun.
Good point. And we'll get into the squares and circles in a little bit. Scalar squares and HAARP rings, guys. We'll be back after the break.
Thank you. Bye.